Planet Rock.
Martin Turner, I tell you, it's lovely of you to come in your pyjamas.
Yeah.
It's a relaxed look.
One of the members of my band calls me a fashion icon.
I'll tell you what, you
want it closer, yeah?
I know, you see. We've got bands playing in the background, you know.
Yeah.
You look like you're miming to other people's music.
It is quite noisy out there today.
So I've just realised I've not got your full, proper official name. I've got to say Martin Turner, ex Wishbone Ash. That's your real name. That's your legal name now.
Yes. There was a court case. One of the original chaps, Andy Powell, registered the name unbeknown to any of us. And we tried to straighten that out. You know, the rest of the original band were rather upset about it. Understandably, I think. And amazingly, it ended up going to court. And they tried to stop me using the name under any way, shape or form. But the judge said, that wouldn't be fair. That would be tantamount to denying a chap his CV. So I'm like, oh, thank you, Your Honour. So the 1970s really did happen. It wasn't just a figment of my imagination.
This is a while ago. Is it ongoing forever, or will there ever be some kind of resolution so you can drop your double barrel name, Wishbone Ash? You can just be Martin Turner.
Yeah. Well, who knows?
You could change it to, I don't know, Martin Turner, school teacher or something like that, and give yourself another double barrel name.
No, I did ask my lawyer, look, if I change my name by deed poll to Wishbone, Christian name, Ash surname, can I use it then? I mean, I did come up with the name in 1969. It is my intellectual property, but apparently not. No, the patents office takes precedence.
Keep looking
for
them loopholes. Keep trying, Mr. Ash.
Yeah.
Keep... So the Argus tour's been going a while. You've got a good few months of it left.
Yes, it's the, what is it, the 45th,
6th
anniversary, or so, I can't remember.
Yeah, it's older than me.
Yeah, it's like another lifetime when we recorded that album, 1972 or 1, I think we started working on it. But big themes on that album.
Yeah, absolutely.
Warrior, throw down the sword, that's a funny story. I mean, the Warrior, I'd been fascinated by the phenomenon of young guys and their energy being harnessed by people that want to make war, you know? So I wanted to write about it in, what would you say, as noble a manner as possible.
Yeah.
You know, not completely slag off the idea of war. But once I'd written the song, I thought, oh, people are going to think that I'm advocating war. So I need to, you know, being a Libran, you know, needing balance.
Me too.
I need to write another tune, you know, that's an anti-war song. So Throw Down the Sword was basically a hymn, much like I used to sing when I was a little lad in the church choir. It's very hymn-like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So are you just going to do the Argus album this year? Then you're going to go do the other albums?
Next year we have ambitions. Well, we are going to play the very first Wishbone Ash album, which will be interesting because...
You can't remember it.
It's not that so much as I can remember it. It's that... Some of that stuff you wrote when you were 19 or 20 years old.
Yeah.
You know, and your testicles were different shape and further up.
Yeah.
So your voice was a lot higher. Mm. And now you've got to sing it, you know, when you're an old age pensioner virtually. And it's a bit of a challenge, but I'll get there.
You will somehow. I'm sure it's a challenge you'll rise to. Well, listen, I did hear quite a lot of you. It sounded very, very good. Listen, there's nothing wrong with what you were saying about, well, it sounds different, but, you know, listen to some of the tracks, even from 50 feet away, it's standing up very well, so...
Yeah.
I doff my cap to you, sir.
Yeah, well, we do tend to do well on these kind of shows, and people, I think, are refreshed by the melodic content, you know, for want of a better word. And really, the Argus album was such a success over a long period of time that you can't go wrong, really, can you?
Well, it's a classic. It is a timeless classic. Yeah. And we look forward to hearing that until the autumn and then the earlier albums into 2018.
Yeah, yeah, we're going to take a look at There's the Rub,
which
is the first album that's recorded in the States, and also the first album,
Martin, it's been a pleasure as always.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, sir.
Enjoyed it immensely.
Thank you, Mr. X-Ash.
Planet Rock.